grid in motion. Teal under heat, and it's Madigan now punting. One of the top punters in the nation, the top punter in the Big East, from his own end zone. A line drive that comes down at the 47, and great special teams. All right, Reese back here, West Virginia with good starting field position on this drive. Jarrett Brown in at quarterback. Headed off to Owen Schmidt. Level and the college level of moving the umpire. Brown completes the pass down to the 35-yard line. Brandon Miles with his first reception tonight, and it's first down Mountaineers. Boy, Jarrett Brown has a little touch on his pass.
Well, the line on Jarrett Brown, we talked to Coach Rodriguez earlier in the week. He's the stronger passer of the two quarterbacks. Doesn't scare you quite as much with his feet as a Pat White, but the ball comes out with some velocity from Jarrett Brown.
First down and 10 from the Rutgers 36. Brown hands it off to Slayton. And Slayton makes it down to the 32-yard line where Green makes the stop. Courtney Green, the 6-foot sophomore for Rutgers.
And one of the big challenges for the Scarlet Knights defense coming in this game is just to get adjusted to the quickness and the speed, the flat-out speed of this West Virginia offense. No way to duplicate that on the practice field during the week.
Second down and 6 for the Mountaineers. Brown keeps it himself and is brought down. Oh, he's still on his feet. Wow, what a play by Jarrett Brown. Appeared to be bottled up. But wow. We're really gonna have to take some inventory if Arkansas wins that.
Can you say Big Ten rematch?
Third and 4 coming up for the Mountaineers. Brown, incomplete, a little bit wide. Intended for Palmer out of the backfield, the fullback. Fourth down coming up. They're on the fringes of field goal range. But it looks like they're going to keep the offensive unit in there with Jarrett Brown.
Yeah, I like this call. You know, you don't pick up a lot of field position by punting the football, especially on a punt that goes into the end zone. Fourth and 4. This is an offense that's equipped to pick up a first down on these types of situations.
Well, there's flags down on the play. Brown goes down back at the 39. The offensive linemen have not moved to this minute. They haven't moved even now. Look at that. Still holding their water.
Well, that is called an on-the-line freeze, and offensive lines are taught to keep their stance.
All sides. On the defense.
State, Glenville State, modified it to Clemson. First down and 10. Slayton trying to get to the edge and cuts it upfield, brought down at about the 22-yard line. Second down coming up for West Virginia, trailing right now 10-3. You know, this game, very important for West Virginia. They can't win the conference championship, but they can, with a win tonight, register back-to-back 10-win seasons and go to a January bowl game.
Well, you look at the bowl implications, and they're serious. So West Virginia can get into the Gator Bowl, most likely, with a win tonight. If not, they fall all the way to the Texas Bowl.
Second down and 8. On the reverse, it's Renaud. He's brought down at the 23-yard line. He's about 6 yards short of the first down. Jason McCourty making the stop on the play. And, of course, the game that really vaulted this program, even more so into national prominence, they beat Georgia last year in the Sugar Bowl impressively.
Right. Impressively, to say the least. And Steve Slayton, over 200 yards, broke a three-decade-old record in the Sugar Bowl set by Tony Dorsett.
And won the Big East Conference. A lot of respect and credibility in the process. Third and 7 coming up. Brown working out of the shotgun. And he put it on the ground. It's loose. And the Mountaineers appear to have recovered the fumble. It was knocked loose by Ramil Meekins. Boy, Meekins and Foster inside wreaking havoc. And, David, that's one thing we haven't talked about is the quickness of that defensive front of Rutgers.
Well, they're undersized, and they talked to Greg Schiano this week. He said, we not only move, but we have to move after the snap. We don't have the size to engage with big offensive linemen. but they've got a lot of skilled athletes that bring pressure up front, and it starts with the co-captains at the tackle positions.
McAfee can attempt this field goal from about 48 yards out. And it comes up about a Britt in motion to the top of your screen. Quick flip to Rice. Protege now. It's a great story. Second down and 9. Teal. Incomplete at the 45-yard line, intended for Britt. Well, Brian Leonard is the school's all-time.
Robinson, the head coach of Syracuse, after the game, by way of the press conference, said, hey, I might have violated protocol, but it seemed right to get him the record at home.
Teal in the pocket. Rutgers has been able to move the ball with relative ease against West Virginia. And Young tripped up at the 49-yard line. And from this magical season unfold. Second down and 10. The backs line up out of the eye. Leonard and Rice. Ray Rice on the carry. Brought down to the 47-yard. Third down and 6. Rutgers with the ball. Leonard in motion. Teal incomplete at the 30-yard line. It was intended for his tight end, Clark Harris, one of the team's leading receivers, hasn't caught a ball tonight. And it's fourth down coming up.
Yeah, Harris, one of the top tight ends in the country. A lot of preseason magazines had him rated as the number one tight end coming in. Hasn't had the numbers this year that he had a year ago, but a big part of this Rutgers pass offense.
Joe Radigan into punt once again, and that is Vaughn Rivers standing on his own 10-yard line. Radigan has 19 punts this year that he's been able to place inside the 20-yard line. Let's see what he does on this one. Hangs it up high. Rivers with the decoy. Arkansas and Florida battling it out. You saw the numbers. First down and 10 coming back the other way for West Virginia. Brown throwing it at the feet of his intended receiver, Reynaud. Second down and 10. An agitated Rich Rodriguez on the sidelines.
Well, you watch both of the defenses tonight. Both defenses getting numbers up on the line of scrimmage. And Jarrett Brown is going to have to hit some balls. He's going to have to get more consistent in the passing game, or the Scarlet Knights are going to continue to load up.
Second down and 10. They're going to run it this time. A gaping hole up the middle that calls D. Slayton's name. Slayton on the move. First down, West Virginia into Rutgers territory. Courtney Green missed a tackle that allowed even more yardage by Slayton. A 45-yard gain.
Now, one of the misnomers about the West Virginia running offense, that it's a finesse running game. Great work up front by the big guys, a very physical outfit, and then the Rutgers secondary getting a taste of Slayton in space.
And David, you notice those Mountaineer receivers blocking downfield too, including Brandon Miles. First down and 10. Brown going to keep it over the right side, crossing the 40 down to the 39-yard line. Hey, how would you evaluate Jarrett Brown getting the surprise start in place of Pat White, who's out with the turf toe and the ankle injury?
Well, he's gotten heavy reps as we watch West Virginia, always in the no huddle status. They're not in a hurry, but you know, Brown got a lot of reps in practice this week, and Rich Rodriguez, he said, we're not afraid to put him in the game in big situations. He has talent as a runner and a throw.
Second and 6. Slayton got drilled by DeBron Thompson, the 5'11 senior. Thompson had played in every game in the 3 years at Rutgers. Makes the calls back there, gets those linebackers lined up, and a nice hit.
Well, the Rutgers defense has made a name for themselves with their attack style defense. Not afraid to come up and meet you face mask to face mask. One of the top defensive units in the country.
Third down and 5 coming up. Brown on a predetermined run won't get anywhere. He's going to lose about 4 yards back to the 40-yard line. Frierson making the stop on the play with 4:40 to go in the first half.
The Rutgers, they saw Pat White out of the game on the opening series of this football game. Their defensive game plan changed, and they're playing a little bit more run heavy up front. They're committing to the line of scrimmage, and they're going to make Jarrett Brown prove to them that he can hit balls down the field and make some big plays to the wide receiver group outside.
West Virginia punting. McAfee going to aim for the coffin corner. He's out there from Ohio State, but certainly it would set the table for next year and his campaign. Fumble. Ray Rice at about three, brought down by McClee. Reese, tell us what's up.
Thompson has done a super job coming in at quarterback for the Sooners.
Third and nine, Young. Brought down short of the first down at the 13. Radigan, the best punter in the conference this year, needs a good one here. A line drive. Rivers fumbles it, then picks it up at the 43. And a nice return.
Country, and they only score 6 points.
First and 10. Brown wisely throws it away. Second down coming up, stops the clock with 1:38 to go. Two timeouts remaining for each team. Well, now here's tonight's Aflac trivia question. Patrick White leads all NCAA quarterbacks this season with 17 rushing touchdowns. Who leads West Virginia all time in single season rushing touchdowns? I might have a beat on this one. We break my 0-for-13 streak.
Are you thinking Amos?
I'm going in that direction. Second and 10, Brown. Incomplete. And no flag on the play intended for Jallo. It'll be third down and 10 coming up.
You look at the first half, just over a minute and a half left here before these teams head into the locker room. And Rutgers learned from that Louisville game. They're playing at home. Fell down 25-7 in that football game. I really like the way the Scarlet Knights have come out. They've been poised. They played solidly on both sides of the football. And I think Greg Schiano would be very happy to go into the locker room with the 7-point lead.
Slayton now, David, split wide as a receiver. Third and 10, Brown. Finds his man complete for a first down at the 26-yard line. Tito Gonzalez makes the reception. 1:27 to go in the half.
Now that was an impressive ball from Jarrett Brown. Flush to his right. He's going to take a little bit off this throw. Drops it in over the underneath defender, Derek Roberson, the cornerback. That's a pretty ball when you can drop it in over an underneath defender and in front of the safety.
Slayton splits out again as a receiver. Brown runs it into the boundary. Derek Brown moving the pile. Gets another first down. That's how far he moved it. Down to the 16-yard line. Got to get to the 16 for the first down. Slayton. Short of the first down. Might have been field goal. Third and short. Brown going to run it. Looks like he got the first down crossing that line. But they're out of timeouts. Thompson made the stop for Rutgers.
And that's what made it critical to pick up the first down on that play, because the clock stops on the first down. Jarrett Brown doesn't have to hurry here. He'll wait for the referee behind him to blow the ball ready for play. And then you go out, go on about your business.
First and 10. Brown going to pass. Up in the air and incomplete. And there's a flag down. Brandon Miles was the intended receiver on the play. Thompson and Green are in the area to break it up, but let's try and figure out what this flag is all about.
Yeah, I think Thompson and Green arrived early. The contact came before the ball arrived. This crew may be talking over whether the ball was catchable. I certainly thought it was.
Either that or it didn't appear to be tipped at the line of scrimmage.
No, they might be talking about a deflection, but we didn't see a deflection with the naked eye.
There's no flag. The ball was tipped. There's no pass interference. Second down.
Well, Jarrett Brown delivering the ball. Yeah, the ball was tipped. I'd say it was tipped.
Yeah, Devron Thompson got it.
I mean, that you can't call a tip on that play. The contact came before the ball arrived. It was tipped by both the defender and Miles.
Second and 10 now for Brown. And he's sacked back at the 15-yard line by Ramil Meekins.
West Virginia's got to hurry here.
Yeah, they don't have any timeouts remaining. The clock running.
Now, that was one of the toughest calls I've seen to pick up the flag on that pass interference call.
Yeah, it sure was, and Brown spikes it to stop the clock. With 17 seconds to go, Devron Thompson tipped the ball.
I mean, when you call a deflection, it's a deflection, you know, between the quarterback and the receiver. This ball is deflected right as the ball arrives. And the contact came from behind by Green. I don't think you pick up the flag in that situation. That's a tough break for West Virginia.
McAfee in now to attempt the field goal from 32 yards out. It's already
first thought going into the year.
32-yard field goal attempt, McAfee. He drills this one through to cut the Rutgers lead to 4 points with 13 seconds to go now in the first half. Well, tomorrow night, be sure to catch the 2006 Bowl Selection Special on ESPN at 10 p.m. Eastern Time. It's also available in high definition on ESPN HD. Call your cable operator or your satellite provider today. For more information, log on to ESPN.com. Rutgers continues to be really the warm and fuzzy feel-good story in college football this year. A little more than a half away, should they hang on, of making it to a BCS Bowl. 2-9 in Shiano's first year, followed by 1-11, 5-7, 4-7. Then last year, David, the big breakthrough at 7-5, and they go to the Inside Bowl.
Yeah, they turned the corner. And you look back to 2001, Greg Schiano's first year at Rutgers. West Virginia beat them here in Morgantown 80-7. Last six games here in Morgantown, Rutgers has lost by an average of 42 points. And I think they have gotten themselves acclimated tonight very well here. 4-point lead. They should be taking that lead into the locker room. And a lot to be decided in the second half here. Remember, West Virginia with the win, they probably get into the Gator Bowl. And Rutgers, so much more riding. They're either in a BCS game, Mark Jones, with the win tonight. They fall to the Texas Bowl if they lose.
It's been a historic year for the Scarlet Knights. Squid kick. Tracks.